Right here in Denver,
freedom is popular.
I'm obviously very, very pleased to receive the endorsement today of the Denver Post.
Now, how's that for a busy week in Colorado? We're getting a lot more attention now because of the convention and because we're growing so fast. We had Obama, we had Mitt, we had Ron Paul, and the one I didn't get to was Bill Clinton.
Things started out with Obama on Wednesday morning. People started lining up as early as 6, and the crowds were overflowing. The senator took the time to address some of the overflow crowds at the Denver University campus before he came into Magnus Arena. So people had some time to kill.
Are you ready to go? So am I.
Fire up!
Ready to go! Obama! Obama!
President!
Obama! Yes, we can! Here we go, Obama! Here we go!
Shout, hey, yeah, shout, come on now.
Kind of made me wonder if security confiscated all the beach balls. There was also a little bit of voter ed going on.
Again, let's maybe say this all together. Ready? The doors do not close. One more time. Ready?
The doors do not close.
The president of the Young Democrats got to announce Carolyn Kennedy. Watch as the audience sags and then suddenly revives when they realize who the speaker is.
There is no doubt that that inspiration encouraged our next speaker to support Barack Obama. Everything I've ever read or heard about Caroline Kennedy
The only particularly new thing in Obama's stump speech was his tribute to Edwards, who had just dropped out of the race.
Finally, let me say a few words about another American who has called us to a common purpose. John Edwards is making an announcement today that he is stepping down from the race. John has spent a lifetime fighting to give voice to the voiceless and hope to the struggling. And at a time when our politics is too focused on who's up and who's down, he consistently has made us focus on who matters.
It was also fun to watch the local Democratic notables, such as Mayor Hickenlooper and Gary Hart, and ex-Mayor Federico Peña, hanging out, chatting, waiting for things to begin. Then, on Friday morning, or early afternoon, there was Mitt Romney. He was supposed to be speaking at a Harley dealership up in Thornton, but instead wound up at a car dealership. It was kind of an odd venue. I didn't get a chance to get in and get any kind of shot or actually hear anything that he was saying. So I had to wait to join up with the reporter's scrum outside after he was finished.
Possibly forecast at this stage what the kind of numbers I'll have coming out of Tuesday will be. I'm hoping to do very well. There are a number of states we think we can pick up. There are other states we think are real long shots. There are a number of states where I'm competitive, and we're going to be fighting in a lot of states. We're advertising in some states, and of course I got the family fanned out across the country. Everybody today is off in a different state, and I expect to do well. But you know, at this stage, I expect to keep on battling and get the nomination. And I'm not going to forecast from anything other than success.
Hey, Governor, two things. One thing, today Governor Huckabee said something that was a little unsavory. He said that you hadn't reached political puberty until you were 60 because of some of the position changes. I wanted to get your comment on that. And also, what role do you think money has played in this election? You've obviously put substantial resources into it. Senator McCain was carrying his own suitcase for a while, as you know you do. What role do you think money has had overall in the outcome of this race?
First of all, Governor Huckabee is always good for a good chuckle. That's another good chuckle. I think the presidency is about something very serious, and while there's occasionally a time of natural humor, I think the presidency is more serious than that comment suggests. With regards to the role of money in the campaign, from my standpoint, it was important enough for me to make my own investment in the campaign, along with raising money from other people. And I was not somebody who was well known in the country. Senator McCain and Mayor Giuliani, Fred Thompson, began with extraordinary name recognition and sound reputation. I had to catch up, and that meant that I had to raise a lot of money and I had to spend some of my own money to catch up to where they were.
Finally, on Friday night, Ron Paul came to the Colorado Convention Center. Unfortunately, and to my everlasting humiliation, I was kind of out of tape, so I got what I could. I was intrigued by the things that the audience thought were meritorious of a standing ovation.
Hamilton established a national bank, and of course, Thomas Jefferson came along and got rid of it. And then, of course, the second national bank came along, and Andrew Jackson, another gold standard guy, got rid of that bank, too. So I can guarantee you, if I am to be your president, I will enjoy getting rid of the third national bank. We're involved in Afghanistan. It's not going well. They pretended that last year was a grand year, a turning point, another mission accomplished in Iraq. And guess what? It was our worst year ever. More deaths last year. So we can't fool ourselves. We have to admit the truth. If a mistake has been made, we have to face up to it and change the methods of what we're doing, change our policy, and get our troops home from Iraq. When we recognize that we want the empire to come to an end, it doesn't mean just bringing our troops home from the Middle East. It's about time we brought our troops home from Korea, Japan, and Europe.
To my everlasting chagrin, my tape quit just as Mr. Paul implied very strongly that if we adhered more conscientiously to the Second Amendment, there may not have been a 9/11. But at any rate, you can see it's been a busy week here in Denver, and I'll be coming at you soon with more Colorado Roundup. It's Corinne McDermott from Denver. For the uptake, of course.